What's happening, people? Welcome back to Teams Hype, episode number 4. Like, guys, we're really excited for this. And of course, with your two favorite hosts, Richard and Koi. Like, guys, from our hype talk to our topical discussion to our trends, like, vitu ni mingi hapa hivi. And I'm really loving the series you're having, episode number 4. Mazi tumetoka mbali, man.
Yeah, and continue engaging with us hapo kwa comment section. Give us your views, give us your thoughts. And remember, our hashtag is hashtag Teams Hype. Changamke hapo kwa comment section.
And of course, as we dive right into it, what better way to start than our topical discussion? So let's get it! Hello everyone, and welcome back to our topic of discussion for the day. And today I think it was somehow interesting, but a lot sensitive, because easy ni vitu za traditions and beliefs that I honestly thought by now, like, they've already been diminished and stuff, but surprisingly they're still there. And this is stuff like FGM and some bit of early marriages, man. But what can you say about EFGM and stuff?
To start with, I don't support FGM.
Yeah, definitely.
But FGM, female genital mutilation, mm-hmm. it's the practice of where you entirely or partially the lady and a female genital, the yake na katwa.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that is FGM. Any injury to mm-hmm. the female genital, yes. Mm-hmm. So that is FGM. Now, of course, it's gonna affect.
Yeah.
That's why we are against it. And that is why. Yeah, the laws na constitution zimekata FGM.
Inakuwa na effects kagani sasa?
Mostly ni health.
Mm-hmm.
Health issues na impact kama excessive bleeding. Mm-hmm. And of course, uki bleed excess unakufa. So those are like two effects.
Yeah.
You can, if akuna precautions, you can contract HIV.
Mm.
Pia you can, unaweza kuwa infertile.
Mm-hmm.
These painful urination, difficulties in menstruation. You know, all those things.
It's really sad. And as you're saying that, I can also, like, because I was reading, in high school, I did a set book, Blossoms of the Savannah. And it was about two sisters. One was called Tayo and the other one, Rezian, I think Rezian. And it was the same like, tradition and beliefs where the father wants to like, sell. Because, I mean, Afrikirianga, early marriages is like you're selling your daughter. It's like you're selling them. So, like, he wanted them to really go. And he wanted to give them off. And so, like, but they were activists against it.
Mm.
But unfortunately, one of them, Tayo, ended up being circumcised unwillingly. Mm. And the other one, Rezian, but she was a tough one. Rezian alikuwa tough. Mm. She was really tough. Like, alitoroka. But in the process of toroka, it was really bloody. It was messy. And then I was like, okay, is this thing a must though? And like, you're the dad and you can see all this is happening. Or maybe you're even the mom was there surprisingly and she did nothing about it. So,
because that hiyo kuchapwa is also an effect, because unaona wengi hawataki.
Mm-hmm.
So unashikwa na nguvu na chapwa.
Okay, unajaribu kujaribu, it's sad.
Kwa effect pia, you lose even trust you kwa families and caregivers, because una feel kama wamenipeleka,
mm-hmm.
you know, unakaa na wasiwasi.
The psychological effects. Yes. Na sasa, because for those two ladies, the main goal was because walikuwa nataka kuwapeana the early marriages.
So wao walikuwa zote mbili, early marriages
and FGM. Na early marriages, okay, unaonanga inakuanga na effects gani kwa watoto?
I think early marriages, of course, we ni mtoto, alafu ndo upate mtoto, si ndio?
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, hautaenda shule. Usipoenda shule, you're not productive to the economy.
Yeah.
You know? Na pia inaleta high risk of domestic violence pia.
Yeah, true. Yeah. And, like, diminishing, for me, I normally feel like it's diminishing the girl child,
yes.
Especially.
You know, it's ending your childhood, na bado ijaisha,
mm-hmm. you know? I mean, it's a really sad thing that we witness in the society and in across generally. But you guys stay tuned, because we are going to talk more about it. Let's see what you guys are thinking about this whole issues in our hashtag Teens Hype. Because next to Ambia Kusu, guest way to, like, we have a superficial guest who's going to be talking about this. What will you tell them?
You know, this is something you don't want to miss, so stay tuned.
Yeah, we'll be back. Afternoon, my people. I hope you make one a fantastic weekend, because here at Teens Hype, we've had a phenomenal stay. Especially now at our Hype Talk, what better time to talk about it as
except now. Because today we are talking about something that has blown my mind, and we are talking with two ladies here. As you can see them, one is called Tayana and the other one is called Tracy. Now, most of you maybe mnazoliza, who are these guys? She's called Tayana. She's the owner of a foundation called the Tayana Foundation. And this foundation deals with issues such as early marriages and FGM. And one thing ilimtriga kwa hii stuff wasi lazima mstick muskizi stories, because you see, for me, I personally thought that FGM and early marriages isn't vitu za kunipea marks in CRE and history. But I never knew that these are real issues that are being faced in our nation, in the towns and everywhere across. So you have to stay connected, because now I'm handing it over to the two ladies, and I'm going to start with you, Tayana. Maybe you can tell us, who is Tayana?
Hi, I'm Tayana. I am currently still a student at university. I am doing double majors in communication and media and marketing. And I'll let her introduce herself first.
It's okay. Hi, Tracy.
Hi.
Okay, maybe explain to us who you are.
Okay, so it depends who I'm talking to, but currently I go by Farmer, but I have many titles because
Farmer is the nickname.
Yeah, farmer is the general term, because I actually farm.
Okay.
Yeah. I produce food.
Kulima.
but professionally, I'm an animal scientist. That's what I studied.
Oh, wow, nice.
Yeah, agriculture, maybe an animal
scientist. Okay, so because today we are talking about the Tayana Foundation, and we have Tayana here. So maybe tell us, what's Tayana Foundation? What does it entail, and nini iko na Tayana Foundation as a general?
Basically, how Tayana Foundation started is some friends of mine, we're almost like a group of 8 or 10. What we usually did before, we'd travel to like children's homes and rescue centers, and we just stay with the girls or the children and just take a day with them and all that. So it's something we've been doing before, even the foundation. So this year, because I've been here for a while, so I figured, why not just open a foundation and just make it an actual thing, like quite professional and all that. We actually make a huge difference, because the foundation will do much more than just visiting. So that is what triggered us to open the foundation officially. And what we do is help girls who go through early marriages and FGM, as well as boys, and also the orphans and vulnerable children.
I'm assuming we're friends. You mean Tracy here as one of the friends? So Tracy, how is the experience working in Tayana Foundation, because it's a multi-big foundation dealing with a lot of issues? So as I say, when we work there, what's the motive of the foundation?
It's sometimes it's a humbling experience. It helps you know more about yourself when you help other people. So going out there, listening to people's stories, touching lives, it makes you feel slightly more human. So it's good for you, and you see the change you're making.
So now to the main topic that I'm personally, I don't know if the viewers are, but for me, I'm really interested in FGM. Is it really rampant? Because I thought it's like it's because constitution imeongelelea na vitu mingi zimeongelelea. I thought it's over. Is it really there?
Yes, it really is. I can tell you, what made me start Tayana Foundation is because I have seen my grandmother do it for the longest time. I used to live in Kajiado, and she's based in Kajiado. So while I used to go visit her and all that, I used to see the work she's doing and all that. She has a rescue center where she helps girls who run away from home because they don't want to be married off at early ages, from even 13. And also the girls who don't want to be circumcised because of FGM and all that. She's been doing it for the longest time. So imagine if kitu nilikuwa naona nikiwa mtoto, bado mpaka sahi is still going on. So definitely it triggered me to like do something about it and not just stick and help her, you know.
So when unajiona like you're the one who's supposed to like carry on from where your grandmother is?
Kutakuwa na yake na kutakuwa na yangu, tutasaidiana.
That's interesting. That's actually noble. But when you go there, do you actually meet with these people, with the girls, and even now that you have your own foundation, I'm assuming, how do you meet the people who are affected? Do they like come to you and tell you like, I'm a victim of FGM, or let me start with FGM before we go to early marriages. So do they come and tell you like, I'm a victim, and then they tell you the story and then you help, or how does it operate?
So personally, because my grandma's rescue center, Ikotu Apu Ushago, So nikisema naenda ushago naenda kwa hiyo shule pia. So we just end up interacting with the girls and all that, and some of them are comfortable telling me their stories, but some of them are not. So the ones who are comfortable will tell you like what happened, what made her run away, or if sometimes the mother can bring her and I'm torosha nyumbani and mleta huko. So it depends on the girl and if she wants to talk about it.
Yeah. And what happens, because I'm eager, so when they come, what's the story? Is it like, do you, when you want to like make the remedy, do you go to talk to the family members, or what do you do to the girls themselves?
Tayana Foundation is still a very new foundation at the moment.
Yeah.
So we haven't had the opportunity to work like in personal cases like that, because it entails a lot of training. Like the board members, we have to go through training to deal with such stories and all that. And we haven't been through that yet, but we're still working towards that. But I have seen like what my grandma does, and yes, she goes and deals with the families. Sometimes the father of the girl will not want to talk to the, to talk about it and will just want to go and still marry her off and all that. But it's something they, it's a process they know it's about. So yeah, and we're still learning to learn about it, and then we'll start handling the cases ourselves.
Do you plan like, because you, now you said you Kajiado alone, have you like spread to know like if this thing is really in the roots of certain places?
Just having like the educational background, it's not just in Kajiado, it's also in northeastern of Kenya and those interior places in the country. Also in Africa, there's some countries as well that also go through it. So, but as much as our home center is in Kajiado, we will definitely be looking into going to other places and doing the same work.
Okay, so yes. Tracy, Kulima, you said, okay, you're, okay, what position do you carry in there? Are you just like a visionary, or are you?
Oh no, I'm the secretary.
Oh, you're the secretary of the foundation. Okay, so experience yako kuwork na hiyo foundation, what's like your experience in it?
Oh no, it was, it's actually a very good experience. Mm-hmm. It's my first, it's a big deal for me because it's my first position in a committee where I'm volunteering, because I do it a lot. But this one I can actually, I'm in the management, and they're a good team to work with.
Mm.
And like everybody went there with, I know what I've come here for. So it's a good heart, it's a good environment. It's actually a very good experience.
So what I want to call first hand comparison stories, where you, listen to these girls and they're seeing what has happened to them.
Yeah, because we interact with them. When we have an event, the girls are there. It's for the girls. Mm. So we'll talk to them, we listen to their stories, have fun. You know, because sometimes it's a very sensitive topic. Sometimes somebody doesn't want to talk to you about it, but you're just there for them and they know they have the support. So.
Okay. Yeah, so when we go, okay, I said we'll start with gym. Let's now go to early marriages. And one thing, okay, one thing that is like triggering my mind, when we talk about early marriages, is it only the girls or is it only kwamba boy pia in our affect?
I personally, until just recently, I personally thought it was just for the girls.
Mm. I actually did.
Yeah, it was just for the girls. Mm. And so it's for the girls, it's basically where the father thinks it's time for her to become married. Naanze kumpea watoto and all that. And then atpate pia ngombe, you know.
Yeah.
So because in Maasai...
So kwa situation kama hiyo, how do you... Because some baba shapa game to toaki. How do you even manage to like get them from the parents? Is it, I see illegal or stuff in that place?
What's it called? You know, in Maasai, Maasai culture, the more cows you have, the wealthier you are.
Yeah.
So if the girl gets married off and the father gets more cows, it means he's getting wealthier. You know. So in such cases, if let's say the mother, mama huyo msichana, and I feel attacking mtoto wake aolewe, you know, because some of them are actually getting the point of all this, like when I get the point of us trying to end FGM and all that. So when sometimes the mothers feel like they don't want the child to get married off, which is, we are trying to end and it's not allowed anymore.
Mm.
So the mother anamtorosha, anamleta kwa rescue centers.
Oh.
Ama anampeleka kwa chief, and then the chief anakontakt whoever is in charge in the area.
So if I'm getting you correctly, you wase uwa mnangoja, you guys wait for somebody in the family to take action so that they bring to you guys.
No.
Because now I'm just thinking, you know, like starting such a foundation, I'm sure mnapisingi a lot of oppositions, especially from the family, when you want to remove like the boy from the dad, when a dad ndo amesema mse anaoa. Don't you guys like face oppositions and stuff?
So the point is, yeah, obviously, because you know, Maasai is also have like elders in the community.
Yeah.
And if they want that to happen, they will try and make it happen. But then, before it happens, I'm telling you experience from my grandmother's side because we haven't experienced
it. Yeah, it's kind of the same.
So what I know for time there, she had like spies within the community. So kukiwa na rumors like home mtoto nataka kuolewa very soon, wanna take action. Like wanaenda wanaambia chief anaenda ongelesha babake. And then if they can change their mind, that's fine. If they can't, they take a step from there. So it doesn't outweighing goja mpaka mama alete mtoto because that doesn't, it won't help a lot of girls.
Yeah.
So kuna all spies when you're going within the community and then they bring the information to the right sources after that.
Yeah. So because you guys are doing other stuff, muna manage, okay, how, because you know, like right now, you know, guys want to do a lot of things, but you guys have decided to take the noble step of starting a foundation that is facing real stuff. Mbona, why not stick on this other side? You know, like most youths are like, and I'm getting you also in university, I'm assuming,
yeah.
And maybe you're also like at that age bracket. Why not, for you guys, why did you not like, go enter into the norm where youths are just like, you know, going any direction they want, taking everything they want? But you guys decided to start a foundation. What was your drive or your motivation?
Personally, it was my grandmother. I can't even touch her, mother.
You do love her. You do love her. I envy the love.
Yeah, it was her. Having to see like what she's doing and all that really pushed me towards it. And then, I study overseas. So nikiwa overseas, I always felt like, because I work there, I always felt like I pesa yote niko nayo but nakutumia sherehe kila saa, I can actually make a difference. No, it's not ni pesa mingi, but you know, nile like I have extra money and then bila kufikiria tu kwenda sherehe every time, I can actually like nikikuja holiday, we do something about it and then we go see the girls, have a good time with them and all that. So that is how it started. So tuliendanga this one time, we were, I think 10 of us, just 10, we didn't do a big crowd, but we raised money like this.
Or the charity, yeah. The charity event.
Yeah, no, that was oh, like even before one. The foundation. Okay, yeah, so I had just like came for holidays and then we decided let's do this, let's go see the girls and all that, spend some time with them. So after we saw what we did on that day and the impact it had on them and having visitors, they actually love visitors a lot and they sing for you.
Yeah.
So after seeing the impact it had on them for that day, we decided, you know, let's just do something about it. Let's make it like something that we do it much more often, not just once at it. So that is what like pushed me. And then, hey, I have friends I've known for the longest time. So,
and then actually I gave them a teaser. You said the charity event, because this thing is new, the Tiana Foundation is new.
Yeah.
You held the charity event to like push it.
To like launch
the foundation. Did you get, who are the guests? Did you have surprise guests, celebrity guests? Or?
Let me tell you, it took us, we started the foundation in...
You're invited to the next one.
Oh, thank you so much. Yeah. I'll be there.
We started the foundation in January this year, by the way. But our first official like launch event was in March 13th. So what, we didn't know the amount of work, by the way, that is there for planning that event. Oh my Jesus. The number of meetings, ish. But we did a very good job. We had over, like in total, I think we were 100 people.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's including the girls.
Including the, I think it was like...
100 people. So this thing is already 100 people.
Yeah, we had like 100 of us.
It's like a new action.
Really?
Yeah.
More than 100.
I was in the kitchen like
that.
See the people.
You were really busy.
So we had like 100 or more people. We had like a whole program and then we had our entertainment area where we had a DJ for the girls. So they play and their songs. At least it was like Kimasai because they love Maasai songs. Wanna dance and all that. What else? We cooked for the girls. We always make sure we cook for them so that we can get more quality time with them. And then at least one other chakula yetu. We also had
games.
It was a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. And then because the charity event was mostly for taking donations and monetary funds and all that. So we were able to raise quite some money, by the way.
Quite some money.
I won't even lie to you. For the money part, it took us 1 week to raise it. Like the last week before March. Uh-huh.
We were just like, we have a short time and we need to raise money. So guys, put your heads together. The money is going to come, but you have to find it.
And pesa ilikuja, ikatosha budget, ikatosha donations.
Ikapita
na bado tukabaki na balance.
I'm telling you, Kenya's on a
hunger. We were overwhelmed by the support we got.
Yeah,
I can feel it.
Yeah. Yeah. And you're still in uni.
Yes.
Doing a double degree. So you're getting a double degree. You're owning a foundation. Like, I don't know, you're hitting bangers. How are you able to manage all this at once? It's a big deal. It's a big deal. Some of us, when you're doing a degree, but for you, you're going into many things, venturing into a lot of things. So,
to be very honest, it's not such a big deal for me right now because
I think you're just humble. But we accept the humility.
No, because in Australia, I would work and study at the same time. And now I'm just studying and it's just online.
Yeah.
So it's not such a big deal. And then, I don't have anything to do. So, yes, the Anna Foundation keeps it busy and all that. And yeah, Nikama working and study. And so I've done that before. So it's not such a big deal.
Now you're Tracy.
Oh, I'm a farm manager. Uh-huh. I have my own farm. Yeah. I produce food enough for a family and enough to sell. And yeah.
So my question is, are you also able to manage? Because though I'm listening to Tayana Foundation, you guys have to be busy planning these charity events. Do you plan on traveling again back to these counties? You know, because you have to.
Yeah, we have to.
So how do you unajiekaje?
But the thing is, like the day you met us, you can tell from our personalities, we're very strong and driven. So we know what we want. And when you know what you want, you don't get
it.
And we're very young, to have energy.
But anyway, before we like complete and we finish this amazing hype stuff that we have for you guys, I can just start with you, Tracy. You can maybe use this camera. You can tell them like something. Just whatever your heart carries and you want to tell the youth, especially concerning this, you guys being in a foundation and you doing all of this just for the nobility. Siju English. Nobility goes out.
Nobility.
For the society. Like Musa Mutambiaji wasi. Okay. If they want to like be like you, because you know now this is like a noble course that you're starting. So what will you tell them? What will you advise them to follow?
A little background on it. I've always been the little weird kid, but let me tell you something. As when you're growing up, there are a lot of uncertainties and everything, but if you stick to, like, if you believe in yourself and you stick to it, you'll be able to do something good. So follow your weird little passion. Try to make a difference in the world. People who actually dream of changing the world changes.
It's not a very big dream to have. I don't have as many words to have, but just honestly, just keep God first. Omba, just pray a lot and do not be afraid to take that step.
Is that what has helped you to where you are now?
And my friend.
And you.
If you have good support, you can do it.
And you've talked so much about your friends. You really love your friends. I only know of Tracy. Are there maybe others who you can count? That's nice.
Yeah,
you talked about friendship and stuff. And really appreciate you guys for talking to us. So I hope you guys have had a good time with the Hype Talk. I hope you've been motivated. It was really a noble cause. Me hearing about it, me hearing how early marriages and FGM are still things that are affecting our society, and hearing from people who actually witnessed it firsthand, it was a really interesting part. But you guys don't go anywhere, because next up, we have the two friends, the two ladies, who are going to be competing one-on-one, you know, our fun and games in Akwanga Moto and Fire. You guys don't want to miss it. So stay tuned and stay connected. We'll be right back after the short break. I hope you guys are ready.
Yes,
we are. See you guys. Hello people, it's back again with the fun and games, and this is actually my favorite because zile vitu tunasikianga huko. So for today, obviously you know who we'd had on our hype talk. I'm going to start with Tracy and then Tayana. These are going to be the people who are going to be contesting today. Na leo, because in the past riddles watu wameshindwa, tongue twisters kwanza the worst, Kikuyu inazumbua watu, but today we're going to put their language into the test. So I hope contestants you are ready. So the rules are this: you get 100 points for each question you get correct, and 0 points for each question you get wrong. Na kama imekushinda, you just say pass. And then for our second part, it's going to be tongue twisters. let's just get there. Watch it to figure out. So are you ready, contestant? You're going to be contestant number one, and you're going to be contestant number two. Ready?
Yes.
Ready?
Yes.
Okay, let's go. So the first question is, what is always in front of you, but you can never see it? What is always in front of you, but you can never see it? Usiangalie sasa hivi utaiona. What is always in front of you, but you can never see it? And time is ticking, time is ticking, time is ticking.
Your
time.
Nose?
I beg to differ. I can see my nose.
No.
I can see it's
you
perfect.
You can actually see it, but random fact, your brain deletes it, so you don't actually see it.
Okay. You will give me facts, but it is wrong. Contestant number two, you pass. The answer is really simple. Your future.
Really?
It's always in front of you, but you can't see it. So it's 0 points for the two contestants. We go to the second one. I think I asked it the last time, but I'm going to ask it in your test. Where does today come before yesterday? Yeah, this is an easy one. We learned it in school.
In the alphabet.
No. How is today an alphabet?
No, like it starts with T before Y.
0 points. Uh-huh. Time is ticking. Unaangalia markings kim hapo. Unaangalia nini? Where does today come before yesterday? Uh-huh. 3, 2, 2.5. You still pass this one.
I will pass anything.
In the dictionary, that's the only time. But it's supposed to be 50 points. Fine. Contestant number one has 50 points and contestant number two is still at zero. But you have a chance to redeem yourself. I mean, tongue twisters, you're not Austrian. I'm expecting you'll be good at this. But before you go there, I'm going to give you the last question, at least Yore Kabota Panda.
Okay.
To give you a chance. Or maybe Kabota Ongezea Zako. And this is an easy one. We've learned it in school and I'm sure you'll know it. Okay, let me find it. Okay. What has words but never speaks? What has words but never speaks? It's actually related to Kenyu Lukume.
Dictionary.
Well,
a book?
Okay, it's a book.
It's a book.
But I'll give her 50 points. Let me just give her 50 points because I want me to
read.
Okay, I'll give you 150 and you'll have 50. But you have a chance because now it's time for the tongue twisters. And I'm ready to hear Utokunyo Maji before Wonge. It's like you, JB Bishop. These are funny ones. So I'm going to start with you. And you have to, okay, so the rules are this. You have to say these ones two times quickly. Ukingoa, nivo. Sawa? Sawa?
Okay.
Okay, let's start. So this one, it said like this. Nine nice night, nurses nursing nicely.
What?
Nine nice night. You can just say after me, nine nice night, nurses nursing nicely.
Okay.
Nine nice night, nurses nursing nicely.
Oh.
Yeah.
Nine nice night, nurses nursing nicely.
Yeah. Now you have to say it faster and two times.
Nine nice nurses. No, nine nice night nurses nursing nicely. Nine nice night nurses nursing nicely.
Okay, she got it correct, but I feel it was slow. How should we take this?
She used it fast.
Missus
said. I'm not a contestant. Okay, be the judge with me. I'm Issa Maraka.
I can't even say it.
because you managed, let me just give you 100 points for that. So you guys are at 150. So you're the one to break the tie now. Because this one, but I'm not giving you the same one. Let me give you a different one. Akina kurumia kukulia.
I had a nice message.
Where she shines, she sits. Wow. And where she sits, she shines. You want me to repeat it for you?
Please.
Where she shines, she sits. And where she sits, she shines.
Where she sits, she shines.
I think this is supposed to be the one to close us off.
Where she shines, she sits.
Okay, now say it. I'm going to tell you the last time.
The last time. Yeah. I can't do the nice
nonsense. Okay, so where she shines, she sits. Uh-huh. And where she sits, she shines.
Where she shines, she sits. And where she
Do we give her a chance to do it? Imagine. But I hope you guys had fun for the fun and games. We've had our contestants, Tiana and Tracy. So I think this one, it's a tie. It's actually a tie.
Wait, that's why you make a good team.
That's why you, okay. It's a coincidence, but.
No, I hate losing. We didn't lose.
but the sheets, it's the highlight of the games. So maybe Tiana, our CEO of Tiana Foundation, you can tell the people that up next is movies coming, so they should not go anywhere but stay intact.
What movies?
Up
next, there's movies coming, so Karada.
Kenny Rada.
Yeah. See you next.
Back at it again, as in kama venye wahenga na wahenguzi walisema kwamba huu ni wakati wa Richard kuwaletea movie hapo hivyo. So you guys be relaxed wherever you are, because I'm about to give you some movies that are about to be your favorite late night snack movies. And the first one is The Dig. Now, The Dig is a movie about a guy, an old man, who hires some people to come and like look over his land, his architecture and stuff, and then they start digging, looking for, some things. Like, it was a really drama, historical movie. And then, surprisingly, they find a ship. And this ship contains some artifacts that was considered of high value in the past. So I won't give you the whole movie. I'll just urge you to go watch it. Of course, we'll give you the teaser. But just before we do so, the movie has a rating of 7.1. That is how it's been rated. Listen, 7.1 is one of the best ratings you can ever see and you can ever be being given. And Netflix has it at 13 plus. So if you're 13 plus, listen, I got you. Go watch the movie. As I promised, see the teaser and you will like it.
Who are those men?
They're from the museum.
Ye gods! Mrs. Pretty, I think you'd better come and see.
Why would anyone want to bury a ship?
I expect this is a grave of a warrior or a king.
But there's more. There's much more.
War's looming. All hands are on deck to excavate before hostilities begin.
The Dark Ages are no longer dark.
Everyone's going to want a piece, and this is your find.
Why else will you be playing around in the dirt while the rest of the country prepares for war?
And for a second movie, let me just give you Fatherhood, because Fatherhood this week has been in my mind, because one of the best actors, literally comedians, called Kevin Hart is starring in this movie. Like any trigger name movies, it's about a father. He's the father in the movie and he's learning how to raise a kid. And apparently, I think the mother died some time back, so he has the pressure to raise. Now, what can you kwambie? Wanaume tuko na shida. Kama hakuna bibi wa kulea. Kevin Hart really struggled. He was showing us like the steps and everything. Just go watch the movie. It's not yet out, but I'm just giving you a tease and a trailer. And we'll put the trailer for you so that you can see it and you can understand what I'm saying. So here it is.
And mommy was the best.
Go to sleep, Maddie.
Maddie, go to sleep. Maddie, go to sleep.
Go to sleep, Maddie.
It's not working though. Well,
she's not a clapper.
Matthew, darling, we think you should move back to Minnesota. You're all alone here. She needs family. Raising a child, it's a non-stop, all day, all night affair.
I look.
You look great.
Don't say it just to be saying it. You look like a king. King of the sling.
Wake up, Daddy! How does it look?
I think it's a new look. I think it's a new hairstyle that can catch on if given a chance.
And now, away from the movies, away from the films and the series and everything, let me just give you music. Music, ukiwa kwa mat, ukiwa kwa dunda, ukiwa mahali. I'm just giving you this music you can listen to, you can go hear them out, because for me, they were one of my best. And the first one is Size 8. Now, Size 8, excuse me, anajitanga Size 8 Reborn. And truly, she is reborn in music because she came with a new one called Yesu ni Mwamba. You just go listen to it. I really liked it. I enjoyed it. You might enjoy it. You might not enjoy it. But I'm just urging you to go listen to it because it was one of my best this week. And for my personal now, let's watch Ningisa Zunap. My favorite now this week for music section is our man, our rapper, Calligraph. Man, Calligraph alituangomengine.